Companies that pay and regularly increase their dividend can provide an incredible benefit to its investors with the ability to focus on the long term. They're among the few asset classes that has the ability to pay an income stream over the long term that can increase faster or with inflation over time. Still, not every company has the ability to pay out increasing its amount of money to their shareholders over time. Indeed, there are only a small few of companies that can be considered dividend king. Businesses with decades of histories with the potential to continue to increase their dividends with years to come. And here are five of those dividend kings that you might want to consider to buy and hold forever. I'm Zeke, welcome to the Dream Green Show. Let's get into it. The first one is Johnson & Johnson, ticker symbol JNJ. Now, Johnson & Johnson has been increasingly gone up over the last 3 months, up almost 14%. It's up 13.35%. And over the last year, it had a big dip. It was up almost 10% on the year, and then it had a big dramatic drop, losing 10% over the course of pretty much 1 week. What caused this was that Johnson & Johnson actually had to pay out one of their lawsuits up to almost $8 billion. It's not completely disclosed, but they did have to pay out a very large sum in the billions. So Johnson & Johnson pretty much had a problem with one of their products, and they had a file, and someone had filed a lawsuit on them, causing them to have to pay out over $8 billion in damages. So looking at Johnson & Johnson, it's a healthcare titan with nearly six decades worth of dividend growth. It has increased its dividends for 57 consecutive years, a testament to the company's strong position in the ever-critical healthcare industry. In addition to that long history of dividend increases, it's one of only two non-financial companies in the United States to sport a covenant AAA debt rating, the highest available. Johnson & Johnson sports a current yield of around 2.6% in its most recent increases in April to 95 cents per share per quarter was around a 5.6% boost from its previous dividend level. Its payout ratio of around 70% of earnings is decently covered for a large, mature business, so investors have a good chance of seeing it continue to boost its dividends in line with its earning of growth over time. So we look at the earnings, you could tell that Johnson & Johnson did take a big hit in quarter four. It's way below its estimated value. Their next earnings is on January 22nd, 2020. That's Johnson & Johnson's. The next company I'm gonna bring you is Genuine Parts. It's currently priced at $102.80. Over the last year, this company has steadily increased up 7.42%. And this company has continued to increase their dividends over the last 63 years. So all the way back in, since 1980, all the way up to its current time, this company has increased their dividend yields every single year for the last 63 years. That's why they're one of the dividend kings. All right, so that's Genuine Parts, ticker symbol GPC. Genuine Parts is perhaps best known as the parent company behind the NAPA Napa Auto Parts store. The company has a 63-year history of boosting its dividends, a tremendous record for any company, but especially one involved in the rough and tumble retail business. A key driver for its substantial success is that it sells auto parts. When the economy is doing poorly, people tend to keep their cars longer as new car sales slump, and older cars need more repairs than newer ones. In addition, people are also more likely to attempt to do it themselves repairs to their cars if money is tight. That combination means that Genuine Parts sales has a decent chance of holding up reasonably during recession, which is why it has such a long history of raising its dividends. Genuine Parts currently sports a yield of around 2.9%, and that dividend consumes around 55% of the company earnings. With the company earnings expected to grow modestly over the next several years, investors can anticipate that it will likely keep its dividend growth intact in 2020 with another single-digit percentage, and that is GPC, Genuine Parts. The next one I'm going to bring you is one of my favorites, company 3M, ticker symbol MMM. Everyone uses their products. MMM, similar to J&J, also suffered a lawsuit during the 2019 year. Currently, 3M over the last 3 months is up 10.71%. If we look at the year, it had a huge drop off. The company was up 16%. Then it had a huge drop off to down negative 15%. So a 30% swing over the course of 1 month. What caused this was also another lawsuit from 3M. It had to do with their respirators and chemical contamination masks that they make. So they make a lot of different products. They make masks that you can breathe in. They make the little sticky notes that you use, cardboard. So 3M actually makes a ton of stuff within their company. Right now, 3M is still down on the year, minus 3.82%, but it had recovered well over the last 3 months, up 10%. This is another company that I should have bought in when the price sale was correct. Over the last 5 years, it's still up 11.68%. All right, 3M, a can-do-it-all industrial innovator. Consumers may know 3M best for its post-it notes, but the company actually has thousands of products across industries from automotive to transportation to healthcare and hygiene. Their broad industry coverage speaks to the company heritage and core strength as innovator. It's because of that innovation that the company has weathered all types of economic conditions to be able to pay uninterrupted dividends for more than a century and increase those dividends for 61 years. And increase their dividend yields for 61 years, guys. 3M currently sports a dividend yield of 3.2%, and that dividend consumes just over two-thirds of the company's earnings, with analysis expecting some small measures of growth over the next 5 years. There's a reasonable probability that 3M will be able to keep that increasing dividend streak alive. So even though they did get hit with a big, large lawsuit, 3M is still expected to increase their dividend yields for 62 years, 63 years, and going on to the 64. They're expecting it to happen for over the next 5 years, just based off the analysis of today. 3M has shown that they're able to be innovators, be able to change with the market over time. So this company has been around for a very long time, increased their dividend yields for a very long time, and one that I'm finding very attractive that I might buy into. The next company is Sysco, ticker symbol SYY. It is a food service distributor with a long history of rewarding its shareholders. If we go to the Sysco website, products category is all about food. So they deal with different meats, dairies, produce, bakery, breads, beverages now. So they pretty much sell everything. Sysco has paid a dividend every quarter since going public in 1970, and including its initial dividends. It has increased that payment 51 times over its history. That's an incredible track record for a testament to the company's laser-like focus on operating effectiveness and efficiency. Sysco is the world leader in distributing food and other products to restaurants, schools, hotels, hospitals, and other such institutions. That makes it a vital link to the logistic chains, linking those other businesses to their customers. From an investor perspective, Sysco offers a yield of around 2.1% and pays out just under half of its earnings of that in dividends. Analysis expect that company to deliver solid mid to high range single digit earning growth over the next 5 years, giving investors reasons to believe the company can continue its half century trend of increasing payments. That is ticker symbol SYY, Sysco. And then next one is Lowe's, ticker symbol LOW. It's just like Home Depot. If you see a Home Depot, probably a little bit further outside of the city, you're gonna see a Lowe's, all right? So Lowe's is a titan in the home improvement industry. Home improvement titan Lowe's can boost its impressive 58-year streak of dividend increases. Similar to the other retail-focused businesses on this list, Lowe's have been able to maintain its longevity because its business is somewhat resistant to recessions. After all, when money is tight, its business is somewhat resistant to recessions. People focus on repairing, maintaining, and upgrading their existing homes rather than buying new ones. That means that Lowe's will still see businesses in a recession, even if it's less during a healthy economy. Lowe's dividend clock in at around 1.8% yields, smaller than the other dividend kings on this list. Still, that's a dividend taking up only around 55% of the company's earnings. Lowe's have room to continue the trend of increasing its dividends as the business grows over time. Analysts are expecting the company to deliver earnings growth at around 15.9% pace over the next 5 years. And if that happens, investors can see a very nice boost over time versus today's modest yields. All right, YouTube. So pretty much I'm going to probably out of those five, I'm going to add 3M and Johnson & Johnson to my portfolio when I see another great buying opportunity. If I would have bought in on those dips, I was still kind of new into investing around those times, but if I would have bought into those dips, I would be up almost 50% right now on both of those companies. But I'm learning as I continue to grow my dividend portfolio. If you have not seen my dividend portfolio, you can click the link right here that's in the box. That'll take you to one of those videos to show you my complete portfolio. But yeah, guys, I'm going to end up adding 3M and J&J over time. If you want to see when I do decide to purchase these stocks, just go ahead and subscribe to the channel below. And while you're down there, go ahead and hit the thumbs up button. It really helps out this channel a lot. But other than that, I'm Zeke, bringing you the Dream Green Show, and I'm out. Peace.